Hey, Sean Jantz here, and I'm currently inside of a live at the money daily trade here on dollar yen. And what I wanted to show for you is not too long ago, I put out a video titled the simple four-step BTG trading process, right? And this is any process that anybody can follow. It's very simple. And there's more to it, honestly, but this is just a very simplistic version that you can use for some little bit of guideline on your trades. There's no rules. There's only guidelines. If you make rule, I mean, you can have like disciplined rules, but it's very difficult to get like concrete rules in trading because it's just so dynamic and nothing static in the market, right? So we just have some guidelines here. So let's do this. Let's go through this process. I am long the blue line right there at 111, big round number. So you can see my trade here. I'm long 111, in at 50. I got 5 hours to get the move that I want. And we'll use either take profit at 80 or we'll use a structure TP target to the upside. So let's take you through the full process of this. Let's go through so you need more and more application using the four-step process. So first things first, we start on the bird's eye view. A four-hour chart, we're looking for content only. Are we overbought or oversold, right? So if we go to this four-hour chart, okay, what are we? It is very, 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 very obvious what we are. We are severely oversold, severely oversold, right? So all the market does is cycle. See how all this thing does is cycle from overbought to oversold? So we want to be buying into weakness and selling into strength, right? Selling into strength, buying into weakness, buying into weakness, buying into weakness, buying into weakness, right? Because all the market does is cycle. And so we know that we want to be, that's our first edge there, is we want to be buying into weakness. And we got 5 hours to get the bull strength to the upside. Now we move on to the next step. It says, is there proven bird's eye view supply/demand, right? We're looking for context. Context is anything on the chart that's telling us what is there on this chart that's telling us that we're likely going to see a bull pop here. This is the process where you really, really start just hammering down, detailing everything you're seeing, trend lines, Fibonacci's, deviations, structure, anything you see that's gonna give you an added edge. So one thing, first things first, we're pretty much here at a 6 month low, right? So we are severely oversold. We're at a 6 month low. And I need to start dialing down into some, start zooming in so you can see some more of this context. If we move to this 1 hour chart, you can see from yesterday we formed a low right there. So it's very obvious that these bulls should seen value exactly where I am buying, right? And so now that we have retraced, I am looking to buy right back where these bulls proven to be buyers on Thursday. Some more context. I am buying right at, look at this, big round 00 number. I've been teaching this for years. Trade around big round 00 numbers. That gives you an added edge. And you can watch all my videos on why and how that works. And then another edge, we have a negative BTG, negative and a half deviation. So that's more context. So on that second step, it's the most important step. Explain bird's eye view context. What are you seeing that is telling you that this chart's going to go higher? Show everything, trend lines. If you're in Forex Mastery course, show your Fibonacci's, show everything, BTG deviations. If you're trading futures, show the value areas. Show everything you're seeing on the context on why do you think that this chart's going to go higher at the level where you're buying. Show everything. What's the next step? Now move to worm's eye view to time change control. Okay, and so this is either a 1 or 5 minute chart, and it says if we're buying, we want to buy on a higher low. So I'm going to take you to that 5 minute chart. And so I noticed here, obviously we had that low right there from yesterday. We had the low right there during the London session, retrace, and then there's my entry, oversold, oversold, right? So we have a low right there. I would go ahead and consider that a higher low right there. Even though it was 24 hours ago, about 24 hours, that's still valid 5 minute candle higher low. So as you can see, this chart is getting severely oversold on the worm's eye view. It is, this is just simplistic price action trading, right? We're getting severely oversold higher than where the last time we got severely oversold. So that is a higher low, make sense? And then we do have some demand sitting right around there. And so that is extremely, extremely important to time these change control higher lows. And it's very obvious that this chart is now going sideways. See how this is forming change control sideways? We're severely oversold. It does look like these bulls want to cycle back up. And then the last step, probably the second to most important one. The most important one is your context on the bird's eye view. Then the most next step, take profits early. Get green and bank it, right? We're not going to sit here for 5 hours. We're just giving ourselves 5 hours to get the bull pop, but we're not going to sit here for 5 hours. We're going to get green and bank it. And we're going to specifically in Nadex, taking profits on our options, that is our edge. Taking profits early is our edge, okay? And so I'm going to take profit at 111.20, okay, which is 20 pips to the upside, or if price goes to 80, then I'll just TP at 80. So you can start generating, if we go back, you can generate, let me draw 111.20 so you can see that visually. So entry and then TP at some structure there at 111.20, and that is just a little bit more than a 0.25 deviation move. Okay, so, and I teach you about how to do all of that in the other videos. But take profits early. Don't sit here for 5 hours. And so I have a percentage of profit at the binary price at 80. Or if we just spike, like literally, if we spiked right now to 111.20, I'm just going to take whatever, how big, I don't care how big or how small that green is. I'm banking it, and then I'm moving on to the next trade. So you just saw the full process of this. Okay, write that down, take a picture of it, and then this is how you need to be recording yourself trading. And then there is no need to stop loss since the stop loss is built in. But if you want to use some mental stop losses, I can look to start exiting this trade around negative 40 to negative 45, just so I can mitigate some of the loss. And I may roll lower down into here, meaning I will mentally stop loss and then I'll look to enter again since I really, really like this. So we'll pause this and we'll come back and we'll watch this trade play out. Quick update, only about 4 more pips and we'll go ahead and TP. This happened really, really quick. You can see, let's go back. So we're just about to that 111.20. See how fast that came in? And one thing you'll notice how I was really, really diligent about entering as low as I possibly could so that I could ride that 5-minute candle buy trigger. So see how we use that worm's eye view so you can lower the risk and increase the reward. See how we had a five, see how I anticipated that 5-minute candle buy trigger? So 4 more pips, I'll TP right there at 111.20. Or if 80 gets taken out, that's the ideal situation. So there's 111.20, it almost went to my 80. So there's, see the 111.20, so we'll just go ahead and TP. Bank that green, it was almost perfect, right? 111.20 almost gave me that full 80. It looks like I probably got filled about $78. So pretty cool, right? So you just saw that that full process, review. We had bird's eye view, I know everything cycles, so I bought a severely oversold chart. We're at a 6-month low, okay? We had bird's eye view demand. We had demand from Thursday. We had a big round zero number. We had a negative and a half deviation. That's what I call stacking the edge, right? And then I moved to the worm's eye view. I timed a higher low change control entry on the 5-minute chart. And then I took profits early, almost 5 hours left on that trade. That's not how this thing works. Just get in, get the move, take profits. It's only 10 o'clock. Now we're on to the next trade. Love it, right? Follow this process. You're not going to win everything, but if you start following this, you should getting upwards of that 60%, 65% win percentage, and that's how you stay profitable, baby. Gotta love it, but you gotta do this. Record it, post it in the Facebook group. I'll watch it and give feedback.